At the end of this video tutorial, you will know how to protect your forms by using Google reCAPTCHA. So, stay with me. So now I'm here at my PHP Store and I have created a new project. I have also created one empty index.php file and I have started my localhost. So if you didn't start your own, please do it. Also, first thing that we need to do in order to protect your forms is to create that form, and after that I will show you how to protect. So I will just create a normal HTML document. I will create just one input, the type will be text and the placeholder will be what is your name. This is just as an example, and we are going to have one submit button. So the first thing that we need to do to implement reCAPTCHA is to go to the google.com/reCAPTCHA, and after that we need to go to click on the get reCAPTCHA, if you are not already logged in please do it. And now you will have the list of all your reCAPTCHA sites that you have been using. And since this is my test account, I don't have any. I just have two that I don't use at all. So first thing is we need to create some label. This is just for you to remember where is your which site. For example, for this one, I will say localhost tutorial. And I will choose reCAPTCHA v2, and here I need to input the list of the domains where I will use this reCAPTCHA. So at the moment I will just use localhost. I will click on the accept the reCAPTCHA terms of service, and I don't want any alert, and I will press on register. After that they will create for us some site key, secret key, etc. So the first thing that we need to do inside the HTML is we need to copy this code and paste it just before the closing body tag. The next thing that we need to do is we need to copy this code and paste it just before the closing form tag, like this. And after that, all we need to do is to write the code that will be on the server and that will verify the CAPTCHA. So I will say PHP, and here I will, let's say this is name of this button is submit, and I will write one if statement where I will test if someone pressed this save button. And if he is, I will just accept all the informations from the form. So I have forget here, name, let's say username. So we will have username equal post username. We will have secret key from here, so our secret key is right here, so I will make sure to copy everything. So secret key equal. Okay, the next thing that we need is response. So the value of our response is this. We need to copy this and we will say response key equal post this. And it is optional to provide remote IP, but I'm going to show you how to get the user IP. We can get it from the server remote address, and that's it. And now the next thing that we need to do is we will just send to the Google secret key, response key, and the user IP, and on the Google they will verify if someone is human actually, and they will return those information to the out. So URL where we will send those information is here. That's provided by Google. We just need to copy and we will just append secret key, response key, and user IP through get method. So we'll say secret equal secret key. Then we have response and remote IP. So say response equal response key and remote IP equal user IP. And that's it. Now we will call the function file get contents. And we'll just provide the URL to that function. We could also write this part here to here, but I just don't want to complicate things. And now let's see what we'll get as our response. So if we refresh, you can see that we have got one new HTML form that we have created, and also we have got the captcha from the Google. So if we insert any data here and press save, as you can see the Google will say success false, which means that our user didn't click on this button. And if we try to click, wait for them to verify and click on the save, as you can see we have got success true, which means the user is not robot and it's human. So as you can see here, this data is in the JSON object and we need to convert to decode that data. So I will say it like this: response, let's say again, equal JSON decode. And now we will have it as an object and we can say if response success echo else echo verification failed. And now let's test again. So I'll say Senaid. I hit save. It says verification failed. And now if I try again and hit I'm not a robot, hit save, it says verification success, your name is Senaid. So that is extremely easy. We just need to do some copy and paste. And if you guys have any questions, please let me in the comments below. And also if you like this video, please like it and share it to your friends. Take care.